Hi DMC family. Today is Monday the 27th of April, day 41 of MCO. A further update today about our brother in ICU. His doctor said he's doing quite well and his kidneys do not need dialysis today. This shows a marked improvement in his overall health. Please continue to pray for a speedy discharge from ICU to the normal ward. Thank you to many of you who have contributed to the Social Concerns Project, which is about 277,000 ringgit at this point. We have prepared this infographic to give you an idea of what has been done so far. It will be shown at the end of this video and also how you can give towards this. I was preparing the material for my next-gen cell group on the Apostles' Creed, the Holy Catholic Church, which means Universal Church, and the Communion of Saints. And whilst preparing for it, a question popped in my head. How many people have been hurt because of church disunity? Then an even deeper question popped. How many people have been hurt by Christians? Romans 12:18 reminds me today about this. This topic is really close to my heart because I have a few close friends who have been hurt by Christians. Some of them even stopped believing in God altogether because of it. Me? I've been hurt too, many times. And I'm sure you have been also. But I also have been on the giving end of it. I was harshly Bible bashing this guy because he got his theology all wrong. But eventually we talked it out and I apologized to him for my pride. So if anything, I'm not innocent from this and I don't speak as one who is holier than thou, but one who has wished he did things differently. Now, if you're one of the people who has been hurt, I want to say a few things to you. First of all, we're sorry. We're sorry for all those times when we thought we were morally or intellectually superior to you. We're sorry for that time when we looked down on you. We're sorry for those times when we talked behind your back. We're sorry for those times when we withheld love and grace from you. We're sorry for those times when we misused Jesus' name for our own agenda. The church, sometimes like a hospital, is full of sick people, not healthy ones. So Christians are far from perfect. We're just like everyone else, corrupted with sin. This, of course, doesn't excuse us from our past and future mistakes, but we're not any better than anyone. So I want to urge you to not put your faith in Christians alone because we can hurt you, but put your faith in Jesus Christ himself. Let Jesus be the center of your focus. Look to Christ. On the other hand, if you're one of the people who have hurt someone else, even if it's unintentional, strip away your pride and selfishness and go make peace with that person. Even if it's not your fault, make peace. If it is possible and as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Romans 12:18. I urge you to look at Christ and through Christ's eyes, not through your own eyes. The good news of Jesus Christ binds us together with his blood. We are together not because we can relate or because we don't get on each other's nerves, but because he brings us together. He shows his perfection through his working in our imperfection. His gospel extends beyond our conflicts and in our conflicts. So I extend this invitation to all those scarred by Christians in the past to come. Come back to church, join a CG, and let's learn and struggle to love one another as we fall in love with Jesus Christ more and more. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we want to thank you first and foremost for sending your Son to die on the cross for our sins. It is through him that we can unite and gather as one body under your Lordship. So Father, whatever conflicts we may have, grant us to go beyond our hurts and pains to forgive for your sake. Grant us humility and wisdom to know how to reconcile with the ones we've hurt or who have hurt us. Let our reconciliation and peace reflect the reconciliation and peace you have given us through your Son's death on the cross. Let this also be how we reflect better what it means to be your church, the communion of saints. And Father, we uphold the entire nation to you that the implementation of MCO will produce the desired results. In Jesus' name I pray, Amen. Now if you like this video, hit that thumbs up and subscribe. See you next week.